Necessary for whom?
For us.
Us is whom? Us is whom? Us is intelligence or us is ego? You are saying, is it really necessary for me to let go of ego? I am asking, who is this me that it is talking?
Like in any situation.
In any situation, who is talking? You are not one, you are two. Who is talking? Huh? Ego? Better. What's your name?
Vaibhav.
Vaibhav, a beautiful, nice, green, supple, shining leaf is covered with a lot of dust. Lot of dust. As happens during summer months. Have you seen that? In the summer months, the trees get covered with dust. And then come the rains. Right? Monsoon showers. Drops of water fall upon the leaf. And the leaf is not one. Leaf is two. The leaf plus the dust. The moment the water falls upon the leaf, it is death for the dust. The dust is washed away, washed down. And the leaf starts shining again. Have you seen how the trees appear so green after the rains? Yeah, because the dust has been washed away. Now the rains are death for the dust, but life for the leaf. So when a voice comes from a leaf and that leaf is covered with dust, when a voice comes from the leaf, is it necessary to get rid of dust? What do I need to ask? Who is talking? The dust or the leaf? If the dust is asking the question, then I'll say no. Avoid the rains. If the rains come, you will die. If the dust is asking that question, then my answer will be avoid rains. Because water will dissolve you. Water will kill you. But if the leaf is asking the question, then what will I say? Rain is beautiful. Water is life. So who is asking this question, Vaibhav?
Ego.
Then what should I say? No! Hold on to your ego. How can I tell the ego that the ego is bad? The ego will pounce upon me. The ego will say, this is my enemy. Will the ego agree to its own dissolution? So whenever you will ask the ego, is the ego important? What will the ego say? Yes, of course, very important. Nothing is more important than the ego. So always ask yourself, who is talking? Who is talking? With whom are you identified? Is the ego talking? Or are you talking? And remember, the interests of the ego are very, very different from your interests. They are not coincidental. The ego will want you to remain a slave. Intelligence will demand that you live in freedom. So you must take sides very, very carefully. These are two opposing forces. Ego and the self. Ego and intelligence. These are two opposing forces and both are within you. That's why somebody has said that you are your own best friend and you are your own worst enemy. Both are present within you. You are not one, you are two. You are two. And these two are always at war. You need to decide very carefully whom are you supporting? Where are you situated? If you support your ego, wonderful, go ahead.